Hey guys, welcome in Mastering Angular 15 from Beginners to Advanced series. In today's lecture, we will understand the change detection in Angular. There are basically two kind of change detection strategies in Angular. One is default change detection strategy and second is on push change detection strategy. First, let's discuss default change detection strategy. It automatically checks and updates the view whenever changes are detected in the component and providing real-time synchronization. In this case, if we get any change in our object or any property of object, then it will reflect on the front end. And let's implement it in our viewStudent.component.ts file. By default, our component have default change detection strategy, but we can explicitly implement it too. And in this component, we get a student object which coming from app.component.ts file. So I'm going in app.component. Now I'm going to write two functions here, one for changing ID and one for changing the complete student object. Let's first implement this change ID function in the TS file. Change ID this.student.id plus equal 1, which means every time I will click this button, it will increment value by 1. Next, I'm going to write a function for the change student, which will change the entire object. Let's implement this function in our TS file. Now let's run the application and see the result on the front end. If I click on the change ID button, it will update the value of ID. Now if I click on the change student button, it will update the entire student object. So this was the default change detection strategy in which Angular decides if the view needs to be updated by comparing all the template expression values before and after the occurrence of an event for all components of the component tree. Then we have on push change detection strategy. The on push strategy in Angular improves performance by updating a child component's view only when input properties change or events are emitted, reducing unnecessary check. For implementing on push strategies, now I'm going to change this default to on push. Now we will test this strategy on the front end. If I click on the change ID button, it will not update the ID. But if I click on the change student, it will update the entire object of student. So in case of on push change detection strategy, it will only reflect the update values on the front end if we update the object. So in this case, Angular gives us a mechanism to declare a component as having immutable inputs to reduce the number of times a component is checked. This mechanism comes in the form of on push change detection strategy. Hope you understand these both the strategies. If you have any question or query, you can ask in comments. But if this lecture is helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.